Good morning. We're happy to be here again on this beautiful Sunday, another Sunday, another day that the Lord has made. And as we come today on the second Sunday of Advent, we are hoping and praying that you are being blessed and God is keeping each and every one of you. Let us pray. Eternal God, our Father, we come now to thank you for this daylight, health, and strength. We thank you just for being our God. We pray now, Lord, that thou will continue to watch over us as we continue to go through this virus season. And Lord, so much is going on. But Lord, we plead the blood of Jesus on this virus and on us, your people everywhere. Keep us safe, Lord, protected in your care. We ask that you remember mankind everywhere. Remember those that are going through the virus. Remember the bereaved family. Remember mankind, Lord, wherever he may be found. And it is in the name of Jesus that we pray. Amen. Amen. Again, we're happy to see you today, to be here today on this second Sunday. And we know that this is going on the third Sunday of Advent. And we just happy to be here and to be in the season of the year. And it is not our intention to hold you long, but we ask that you pray with us as we will bring you our scripture lesson coming from 1 Thessalonians, the 5th chapter, the 23rd verse. And it says, "Now may the God of peace himself sanctify you completely, and may your whole spirit and soul and body be preserved blameless at the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. He who calls you is faithful, who also will do it." Amen. We want to talk this morning just for a few moments about Jesus is coming. Amen. He's coming. Again, when we think about Advent, the word Advent means to come. And when we think about the Advent season, it is, we begin Advent on the fifth Sunday, first Sunday, second Sunday, third Sunday, and coming up to Christmas. And we call this the Advent season. And so therefore, we're looking for the Savior to come. And when we think about our society, now look around us, I see Christmas lights everywhere. I see decoration. People are hustling, bustling, trying to meet the deadline. And children are being extra good now because they know Christmas is almost here. And so they're looking to celebrate for Christmas. But to the church family, it's more than just about lights. It's more than just about gifts and all of that. We know that it is about the coming of Christ. Advent is the season when our Lord sent his only son, baby son Jesus, to come and to be our Savior. And so today when we think about he's coming, Jesus Christ is coming. And so we celebrate every year this time to remind us to remember that even though he came the first time, that he's coming again. Amen. And church folk ought to be happy. We ought to be happy this morning to know that our Lord is coming and that he's coming back again for the second coming. Yeah, the second coming. You know, we need to be reminded. People need to be reminded today that he is coming. Amen. There's some things we need to know because we know that he's coming. We need to know that there's three things we need to know, that if Jesus is coming, one thing we can say that help is on the way. Yeah, yeah, when Jesus comes, he's coming again. He's coming as our helper. And he's going to make everything all right. When he comes, when we think about him coming, as that baby in Bethlehem, we know that he came in order to help us. We were in such bad shape that we needed a Savior, and God sent Jesus. In the little town of Bethlehem, born in a manger, so that we could have him. And I'm glad today to know that because he's coming, I've got him. Amen. Your own family members, people around you won't help you, but I'm so glad today that if you call on the Lord, he will come to your rescue. I'm glad today that if you call on him, he'll help you. That's why he's coming. Not only that, because it also ought to remind us he's coming because it gives us hope. Hope to know that Jesus is coming. It gives us new hope. Yeah, because he's on the way. Yeah, my brothers and sisters, I've got hope. You ought to be reminded that if Jesus is coming, there's help. And not only help, but there's hope. I don't know about you today, but I hope. My hope is built on nothing less than Jesus' blood and righteousness. I have a hope in him today. Amen. That when my Lord comes, everything going to be put in place. I've got hope today that God's going to make a way for us. Even in this pandemic season, I plead the blood of Jesus upon you. God's going to take care of you. I've got hope today because Jesus is coming. And not only that today, but because we know he's coming, my brothers and sisters, it ought to remind us that we ought to be able and be encouraged to live holy. Yeah, if you know God, Jesus Christ is coming, we ought to live holy. We ought to live like God want us to live. Amen. That's what in this 1 Thessalonians, the 5th chapter, 23rd verse, and may the God of peace himself sanctify you completely. And may your spirit, soul, and body be preserved blameless at his coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. And he who is called you is faithful, who will also do it. My brothers and sisters, when I realize that the Lord is coming, I'm encouraged to live a better life. You ought to be encouraged in this Advent season to know that Jesus is coming back again. And because he's coming back again, I want to live holy. I want to live right. I want to live so that God, if he comes as a thief in the night, that I will be ready. My sisters and brothers, he's coming for a second time. And you better be ready. Somebody says you ought to get your business fit, and somebody else say you ought to have your house in order, because he's coming again. And when he comes, he's looking for us to be ready. And so, my brothers and sisters, we need to be looking in these last days, these evil days, and the way the world is now. We ought to be continually looking for Jesus, because he's coming. And when he comes, he's going to have his reward with him. And so as we continue into that this season, keep hope alive. Realize that Jesus is your help. Be encouraged to live right. We ought to be able to do better than we used to do. We ought to live better than we used to live. Today ought to be better than yesterday. I'm glad today to know that Jesus is coming, and I remind you that he's on his way.
comes back, you'll be ready to go back with him. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for sending Jesus, our Savior, our Deliverer, our Savior of the world. Thank you, Lord, for sending him to this world. And not only the first time, but he's coming again. And I'm always reminded that he's all I need. I'm always reminded that he'll give me help. I'm always reminded that my hope is in nothing but him. And I'm also reminded that I've got to live so holy, because God expects us to be holy. Live a holy life. Love one another. Do the right thing. And I declare, if you do it, God will get glory out of your life. So I thank you, Lord. Thank you, Father God. Thank you for sending Jesus, for he's everything. I love you, Jesus. Thank you for coming for a sinner like me. Thank you for coming to a sinful world to make a way for us. And we thank you today, Lord. Now, this is our prayer now, and it is in Jesus' name we pray that you continue to bless mankind everywhere. Be our God. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.